Hey y'all, welcome to another WordPress Wednesday. My name is Corey Ashton here in San Antonio, Texas at WebTegrity, and you have found a YouTube channel solely dedicated to all things WordPress. Today we're going to be looking at a super simple, easy fix on how to embed your Twitter feed inside of maybe your sidebar or widget area or even a page or a post inside your WordPress website. Super easy, and the exciting thing about this is it is a totally free option. Wow, free is always in the budget, and it doesn't require a plugin. Right? That's crazy. You know, if you watch my channel consistently, that I say try not to use more than 12 plugins at one time. The purpose for that is we start to see a website bogged down more and more and more the more plugins you're using, right? So I'm always excited whenever I find a solution for our YouTube fans who that doesn't require a plugin and is free. So here we go. I'm going to show you initially what I'm talking about for embedding a Twitter feed. You can see this solution here on this right sidebar. It looks like just one Twitter post, but as you scroll down, it's an entire timeline from tweets from this one specific user. So I want to show you how to do that super easily and quickly inside of your WordPress website. So I'm going to post this link to this specific page in the description box below. This is a resource specifically created by Twitter for you to embed something. So what would you like to embed? And you can choose from any of the options here. One specific tweet, an entire profile maybe, a handle. You can do anything like this, a collection even, which is super crazy cool. Not too much more advanced than what I'm going to show you today. And if you'd like some more information about that, be sure to comment below and I'll try to come back and do a follow-up video on that. But for now, I'm going to say that we want to embed WebTegrity, and I'm going to click enter, and scrolling down now, these are my two options. I'm going to do an embed timeline, and then there it is. And this would be the nerd code that I would take over and drop into my widget. But I want to show you one other quick thing. This shows you kind of what my timeline could look like. But what if I wanted to customize it a little bit? There are some options right here to set to customize. So you can set a specific height, then let's just say 500. You can leave the width open so that it's responsive. Would you like it to be a darker design? If you have a darker website, you can opt for that. I'm going to stay with lighter. You can set the default color so that it matches your branding a little bit more. And what language would you like? I mean, all this is super cool. Click update, and that updates our nerd code here. Once you click on it, it's copied to your clipboard, and you can jump right over to your WordPress theme. Are you excited yet? Here we go. This is how you get it inside of this little sidebar over here. Check this out. Inside of my theme, I'm using the 2017 theme. I'm going to go inside of Appearance and go to Widgets. And this is my blog sidebar. This is my main sidebar for my blog area. And I am going to look for just an open text box. Drag it up and put it at the top. And I'm going to go to the content area and paste in what was on my clipboard. That's the Twitter timeline nerd code that creates that cool little feed. And I'm going to say, follow me on Twitter, right? And then I'm going to go ahead and click save. That's it, y'all. As I jump back over here and click refresh, super excited to say, here are my tweets. It says, follow me on Twitter. Here are my tweets. I can scroll through the different timeline, and of course, it stays up to date. So as soon as you publish a new tweet, it's automatically going to appear inside of that timeline. How cool is that? Super easy to do, and if I went too quickly, you can always click pause or rewind. Let me know what you think about it, and if you have a question for your WordPress website, be sure to not only subscribe to our channel, but give me a tweet or send me an email. I'd love to hear from you. Bye, y'all.